when David was brought to the king to defend his cause, he simply testified of how God had delivered him, saved him, rescued him from the mouth of lion and bear in his tender age. Today, when we come out for testimony, it is nothing but the immediate goodness of God. Remember the sickness you had in the past. The same sickness others had and died. Why many others are still on the sickbed? Life is in stages. No matter how good you are, no matter how clever you are, there is always another level to reach for. Those who are rich in every sense of word understand that life is a learning experience. Those who are rich in every sense of word understand that life is a learning experience. When you constantly strive to improve, you build character. And we Christians enjoy the opportunity to be a coach to others.
I come to say how much I adore you. Lord, I'm not here to complain about my many problems. By your spirit and your grace, I'm confident you solve them.
Be seated. Hallelujah. Today's message, my testimony. We shall watch a documentary on who is T.B. Joshua and the Synagogue Church of Our Nations. A lot had been said by people concerning how the church synagogue came into being. Some people questioned my foundation. my mentor, my educational background, and my calling as a man of God. I am not showing this documentary because people questioned my foundation, my background, my mentor, my educational background, my calling as a man of God. I am showing this because it is God's time. That is, it is out of God. Stay blessed and wash.
This is Prophet T.B. Joshua at a prayer mountain. Guided by the Holy Spirit, Prophet T.B. Joshua came to this prayer mountain to seek the face of God. Like prophets of old, he fasted and prayed for 40 days and 40 nights, as prayer and fasting opens the door for God to enter.
It was at this very prayer mountain that Prophet T.B. Joshua received divine anointing from God to start his ministry. As he raises his arm to heaven and then falls prostrate into prayer, he received a covenant from God concerning his calling. Only he and God know the divine message that was revealed to him at that moment. Concerning this experience, Prophet T.B. Joshua said,
I was in a trance for 3 consecutive days. Then I saw a hand that pointed a Bible to my heart, and the Bible entered my heart, and my former heart immersed with the Bible immediately. Then the awareness came, and I saw the apostles and prophets of old with someone who I could not see his head because he was tall to the heaven and suspended, which I believe was our Lord Jesus Christ, sitting in their midst. I also saw myself in their midst. After a while, I saw a hand of the same tall man. I could not behold his face, which was glittering with an unimaginable light. But other apostles, I could see their faces, particularly apostles Peter and Paul, prophets Moses, Elijah, and others. Their names were boldly written on their chest. I heard a voice saying, I am your God. I am giving you a divine commission to go and carry out the work of the Heavenly Father. At the same time, the same hand of the tall man gave me a small cross and a big Bible, bigger than the one that entered my heart, with a promise that as I keep pressing in his time and name, I will be given a bigger cross. But if I fail, the opposite would occur. I also heard a voice of the same tall man, I could not see his head, saying, I am the Lord your God, who was and who is. Jesus Christ, giving orders to all the apostles and prophets. The same voice said to me, I would show you the wonderful ways I would reveal myself through you in teaching, preaching, miracles, signs and wonders for the salvation of souls. Since then, I have been receiving in my vision, every year, according to my faithfulness to God, a bigger cross that means to me more responsibilities. The Bible that entered my heart symbolized spirit and life, the Holy Spirit. God's word is spirit and life. He does nothing without his word. The book of Romans 8:16 says, God's spirit joins himself to our spirit to declare that we are children of God.
This divine anointing is performed by God himself on all who have the wonderful privilege of becoming his children. It accompanies the conversion of those who trust in Christ. Paul said that the Spirit indwells every believer, and his presence is the guarantee of our future glory in heaven, according to the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 21 to 22. As a result of this indwelling presence, we have the ability to become more like Christ in accordance with 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 17 to 18. We who are born of God have no excuse of remaining as we are. We can be increasingly conformed to the image of Christ by yielding ourselves to God's anointing, the Holy Spirit, who dwells in our hearts. Father, thank you for your Spirit. Fill us with His love and power. Change us into Christ's own image, day by day and hour by hour. Remember, the Father gave us the Spirit to make us like His Son.
Our picture on Chairman was displayed to my annual. Chairman, you are just give us a good one. Yes, at that time I will not have time for all this.
The man of God said that by the time the glory of God is revealed in his ministry and people from other countries start coming, he will no longer have the time to visit this prayer mountain, and that in the future he would have his own prayer mountain. This is a picture of Prophet T.B. Joshua praying for people after just having returned from a 40-day and 40-night fast at the prayer mountain. During the early years of his ministry, Prophet T.B. Joshua did not have a vehicle to move around in. He walked almost everywhere he went for 2 years. The children surrounding Prophet T.B. Joshua are among those he gathered to follow him as he went to form the first synagogue church of all nations. This is the first site and the first structure of the synagogue church of all nations, where Prophet T.B. Joshua, having just returned from the prayer mountain, lays the foundation of the church, located in Agodo, Igbe, Lagos, Nigeria. Prophet T.B. Joshua walks joyfully among the members as he lifts their faith with the word of God.
Amen!
Amen.
In fact, I don't know where to start. My coming to your midst, in fact, is just to lay a foundation. Today, we start synagogue here.
Amen! Amen.
When you look at the book of John 9, start from verse 6.
Worship is gathered at the second church building of the Synagogue Church of All Nations that was built to accommodate the increasing number of members. Prophet T.B. Joshua moves in their midst and prays for them. Due to a violent thunderstorm, the second church building of the Synagogue Church of All Nations was completely destroyed. After the second church building was destroyed, another building was built, this time using wooden planks. The first church service was held at a new building of the Synagogue Church of All Nations in 1992. The man you're seeing now, although difficult to recognize, is Prophet T.B. Joshua at the age of 29, ministering to the members. This is Prophet T.B. Joshua's first crusade in 1992. Listen to him as he addresses the people in his local dialect. Prophet T.B. Joshua prophesies to the people, saying, "We are in a small crusade now, but in the future, it is going to be big." One might question why a church of just a small number on the outskirts of Lagos, Nigeria, should be called the Synagogue Church of All Nations. But this is the vision God had given to Prophet T.B. Joshua.
Whatever situation you are going through serves a purpose. It may be to stop you a while in order to reform you. It may be to strengthen your desire. Remember the man at Pool of Bethesda. It may be to keep you for a new level in life. We have seen people who spent many years in the prison, from prison to the throne. This is my story. This is my song.
Raising my Savior, all the day long. This is my story.
This is my story.
This is my song.
Thank you. First Samuel, chapter 17, verse 37. The Lord who delivered me from the power of the lion and from the power of the bear will deliver me from the hand of this Philistine. That is David. When David was brought to the king to defend his cause, he simply testified of how God had delivered him, saved him, rescued him from the mouth of lion and bear in his tender age. Today, when we come out for testimony, it is nothing but the immediate goodness of God. Remember the sickness you had in the past. The same sickness others had and died. Why many others are still on the sickbed? Life is in stages.
Here is Prophet T.B. Joshua surveying the church premises after heavy rain had once again caused flooding. Prophet TB Joshua is carrying a plank of wood to assist in rebuilding the church. Prophet TB Joshua is packing sand along with members of the church to repair the damage that was caused to the first church structure due to the heavy rainstorm. Due to the increasing number of worshippers attending the church, the Holy Spirit instructed Prophet TB Joshua to move to a new location to accommodate the influx of new worshippers. In 1994, the church moved to Ikotunegbe, Lagos, Nigeria. This is the fourth building of the Synagogue Church of All Nations, the first building at a new site. Inside the church are thousands of people joyfully receiving the word of God. After the service, the man of God returns by motorcycle to his personal place of sanctuary, his own prayer mountain, located 15 minutes from the church.
Here is Prophet TB Joshua at the age of 32. He was the overseer of the Synagogue Church of All Nations, while at the same time cleaning the toilets of the church every day for 3 years. One may ask the question, why did Prophet TB Joshua keep such a detailed record right from the beginning of the life he lived? He is a man of vision, and his vision was inspired by the Holy Spirit. It has God behind it for its accomplishment. Every day for 3 years, Prophet TB Joshua also cleaned the sewers of the Synagogue Church of All Nations by hand.
Life is in stages. This record shows that there are different stages I went through in life. Each stage served a purpose. What are you going through as a Christian? Tell your neighbor, are you a Christian? Whatever you are going through serves a purpose. It may be to stop you a while in order to preserve you. It may be to stop you a while in order to prepare you for the challenges ahead. Tell your neighbor, whatever you are going through as a Christian served a purpose.
Just a little while longer, I wanna pray. Can get you on my mind so I can say thank you, Lord. Just for loving me, all right. Many times I do forget every need that you have met. Oh, thank you, Lord. I know you're showing me you are there when I am down and out. You're holding me. Your love is so amazing. Oh, it's changing me.
Worship
you.
Hallelujah, you may be seated. Whatever situation you are going through serves a purpose. It may be to stop you a while in order to reform you. It may be to strengthen your desire. Remember the man at pool of Bethesda. It may be to keep you for a new level in life. We have seen people who spent many years in the prison, from prison to the throne.
I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting on you, Lord. I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting on you, Lord.
Thank you. You may be seated. In the college of God, however brilliant you may be, you will not be given double promotion. You will take every course. In the university of God, however brilliant you may be, you will not be given double promotion. You will take every course. Because each course serves a purpose.
Imagine the rumors and gossip that spread as a result of this incident. A prophet detained in a cell for taking drugs and harboring weapons. However, his enemies soon noticed that not even the detention in a cell and false accusation could shake his faith in God. To the wise, this was a foolish thing, but God used it to reveal his purpose in the life of TB Joshua, giving him the necessary experience and maturity to handle the greater responsibilities God was preparing for him. Like Joseph in the Bible, he has learned what it is to be loved, hated, rejected, enslaved, accused, and falsely convicted. He bore everything that happened to him calmly. This is the letter from the National Drug Law Enforcement Agency confirming the innocence of TB Joshua and clearing him from the charge of drug dealing, for which he was detained in a cell for 13 days. Remember, our enemies may rob us of our liberty and confine us in a prison cell, but they cannot shut us out of the throne of mercy and communion with God. Falsely accused of drug dealing by the NDLEA, National Drug Law Enforcement Agency, TB Joshua was arrested and held in a cell for 13 days. This is the first appearance of TB Joshua, having just been released from the cell. He addressed the congregation, thanking them for their faithfulness and love, for standing by him in the hard times, referring to their unequal effort towards his absence. You can see the man of God TB Joshua looking lean, having spent 13 days in the cell.
Yes. I will use this opportunity to thank you all for your unequal efforts towards my absence. So I'm here to thank you all. God bless you. I'm so being with you people. If you now stay this in your mind that why me about all this trouble, persecution, tribulation, all sorts of things, I want you to now think back again. Why me about remember the blessing of God, like food, shelter, and many other things.
Having searched and found nothing against him, T.B. Joshua was released from the cell, and the following Sunday appeared in the church service to thank the members and appreciate their love and support during his absence. Rather than to complain and query, "Why me of all this trouble and persecution?" T.B. Joshua encouraged the congregation to remember the spiritual blessings many are denied of, such as food and shelter, that they can hold the very word of God in their hands and read it, that they have the knowledge of his saving grace. The man of God encouraged them, saying, "When you begin to count your blessings, your doubts would fly away."
In the college of God, however brilliant you may be, you will not be given double promotion. You will take every course. In the university of God, however brilliant you may be, you will not be given double promotion. You will take every course, because each course serves a purpose. Right from the beginning, I knew that I must taste poverty in order to manage blessing.
Hundreds of benches and fans were installed inside the new church for the thousands of members that came daily to attend the services. Not only did Prophet T.B. Joshua minister to the congregation, he also gladly and faithfully cleaned the fans and benches daily. There were hundreds of them. He cleaned them all. As Colossians chapter 3, verse 23-24 says, "Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as working for the Lord, not for men, since you know that you will receive an inheritance from the Lord as a reward. It is the Lord Christ you are serving." He is seen here cleaning the floor of the entrance to the church. As is his practice, T.B. Joshua regularly takes time out to share food with the children and enjoy their presence. Occasionally, T.B. Joshua can be found sitting among the children in their Sunday school class and visiting the babies in the nursing mother section of the church. He is an integral part of every department of the church. Prophet Prophet T.B. Joshua is returning from a quiet moment of devotion in prayer at the Prayer Mountain to resume his activities at the church. After conducting the Sunday service, Prophet T.B. Joshua would usually join the members in the canteen. He serves water to the members. This is one of the services in the first building at the new site of the Synagogue Church of All Nations. In fulfillment of the prophecy given by the man of God at the Prayer Mountain, here you can see hundreds of people from around the world who have come to listen to the Word of God that Jesus Christ has revealed to His servant, Prophet T.B. Joshua.
Right from beginning, I knew I must taste tribulation in order to manage freedom. Right from beginning, I knew I must taste condemnation in order to manage praises. My objectives, right from beginning, and my motives were determined at once. I wanted what God wanted. I wanted it for the reason God wanted it. Those principles anchored me through my teenage years. They guided me. They were the fountain stone of my life.
You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy sea. I am strong.
You babysitter, thank you. They were the fountain stone of my home and the raisin of our evangelists and pastors to be. People of God, God has a time for everything. A time to be born. A time to grow. A time to face persecution. A time to overcome. And a time to show the proceeds of victory. Ask your neighbor, what time are you in? Nothing happens by chance. Unless you understand this, you will continue to murmur and despair when what you want seems not to go the way you want it. In the college of God, however brilliant you may be, you will not be given double promotion. You will take every course. In the university of God, however brilliant you may be, you will not be given double promotion. You will take every course. Because each course serves a purpose. People of God, God has a time for everything. A time to be born. A time to grow. A time to face persecution, a time to overcome, and a time to show the proceeds of victory.
During the rainy season, heavy rainstorms continue to flood the entire church premises. This is Prophet T.B. Joshua in the rain, in a dark colored jacket. Prophet T.B. Joshua works alongside the members to rebuild a wall that had been destroyed by the storm.
One life for Jesus is all I have. One life for Him is so dear. It's my love, my joy, my strength, my all. Without Him, I will fall. Everybody desires breakthrough. Whereas God sometimes uses disappointment to keep us for a new level. Everybody desires breakthrough, whereas disappointment sometimes used to prepare us for the challenges ahead. Everybody desires breakthrough, whereas disappointment sometimes used to reform us for a better position in God. Everybody desires breakthrough, whereas disappointment sometimes used to strengthen our desire for God. Ask your neighbor, who knows what could have happened if your prayer for better condition had been answered?
God's time is the best time, for I know my time doesn't matter. Who God's time, God's time, He's the best time, for I know my time doesn't matter. For everything has to do with God, it's here, there's a time to be born, and a time for your time, Lord.
Lord, for your time.
I choose to wait.
I choose to wait.
Only for you.
Only for you.
I choose to live.
I choose to live.
My path
my
behind.
Path behind.
I choose.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. When you know the principle of life, you will always reflect on life itself rather than the situation you are in. The principle of life is that nothing happens by chance. Are you without strength, without smoothness of tongue, fast legs? There is hope. Jesus is the hope. This record is not saying, I have arrived. Remember our message here. Better is not good enough. As a Christian, situation you are in serves a purpose. You need to know the purpose it has, so that you stop grumbling, you stop murmuring. In the biblical characters, from Genesis to Revelation, nothing happens for nothing, and nothing comes by chance. In the biblical characters, you will see how much pain, how much hardship, trouble, tribulation, persecution, hatred, setback, sickness, disease, they endure to come to a new level in life. I know the persecution I went through while the Lord doing to strengthen my desire, to keep me for a new level in life. I know the hatred, the isolation, name calling, intimidation are the Lord doing to preserve me. The Lord used it to bring my real value. The Lord used persecution to bring my real value. When you are your real value, you see life the way God sees it. You begin to see yourself the way God sees you. You work with God's project. You get God's opinion about yourself and about others when you are in real value. Let someone say real value. Real value. That is what you want. Not in the eyes of people, but God. When you are in your real value, you live contentment life. Life without complaint. in the biblical characters from Genesis to Revelation, nothing happens for nothing, and nothing comes by chance. In the biblical characters, you will see how much pain, how much hardship, trouble, tribulation, persecution, hatred, setback, sickness, disease, they endure to come to a new level in life.
Welcome to a Sunday service at the Synagogue Church of All Nations. TB Joshua is busy delivering an anointed message to the congregation. What is that noise? Where is the prophet going? See the crowd rushing through the streets. Where are they rushing to? What we're seeing is frightening. Armed robbers are shooting on the streets outside the church. See the man of God walking with boldness and confidence. He has moved straight to the robbers. See the people scattered. What happened? Well, let's follow the prophet and the crowd back into the church. The prophet is making his way to the altar. What's in his hand? It's the gun. The prophet has collected the armed robber's gun. This can only be the work of God. As the Bible says, if you're a man of faith, fear of armed robbers is nonsense. Fear of guns is foolish.
The purpose of this record, first, to show my total dependence upon God. That is, one life for Jesus is all I have. One life for Him is so dear, is my love, my joy, my strength, my all. Without Him, I will fall. And to tell the weak that there is hope. Jesus is the hope. Are you without strength, without smoothness of tongue, fast legs? There is hope. Jesus is the hope. This record is not saying I have arrived. Remember our message here. Better is not good enough. It's my way of showing my thanksgiving. Tell your neighbor, no matter how good you are, no matter how clever you are, there is always another level to reach for. Those who are rich in every sense of word understand that life is a learning experience. Those who are rich in every sense of word understand that life is a learning experience. When you constantly strive to improve, you build character. And we Christians enjoy the opportunity to be a coach to others. Open your lips. Begin to ask God to remove the hands of evil spirits from the affair of your life, so that you can see life the way He sees it. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. This is your hour. This is your day. Amen. This is your time. Amen. Open your lips. Continue to ask God to remove evil hands from a fear of your life. Prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Ask Him, don't let my situation escape the anointing of God. Prayer.
Élève la main et prie. Dis, Seigneur, que ma situation n'échappe pas à ton onction. Demande à Dieu d'enlever toute main d'esprit impur hors de ta vie, hors de tes affaires. Élève ta main vers Dieu. Élève la voix et prie.
Estamos en el tiempo de oración donde el profeta ha dicho: remueve toda mano de Satanás de los asuntos en mi vida. Ore. Remueve toda mano de Satanás en todos los asuntos de mi vida. Tiempo de oración.
Demande a Dieu d'enlever toute main de
malédiction. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen.
This is your day.